Pour yourself some bourbon, tea, whatever you drink. This is going to be a different kind of video. You are going to get to watch me create a solution from scratch. I am starting with a butt-ass naked spreadsheet. I want to replicate what Magico Galvan created. Here is what Magico Galvan did. He had a list of names and information about these people. And in a final column, he had active or inactive. For active people, the font was fine, but people wound up on an active table. If they were inactive, the font would go gray and they would automatically wind up on an inactive roster. And I think this is pretty simple to do, but I just thought that it was so interesting. There are uses for this kind of a thing. And I am going to take this a step further and do kind of a miscellaneous or unassigned section. What I really want to do here is just show you my process. And I am sure that once I'm done, there'll be cleaner ways to accomplish this, but it's more about the process of figuring it out. So here is my butt-ass naked spreadsheet. I need some fake data. So let's do this. So we need a name, age, email, and active or inactive. So I'm going to go over to my spreadsheet where I have all of my data. I've got this many names here. All right, so I'm going to grab a bunch of names. Now here is the easy part. All right, because I see filter and conditional formatting playing in this. Equals filter, open parentheses, filter what? This array. Comma, include where this column equals, I'm gonna put it here, an F4. Comma, if empty, none, double quotes, close parentheses, enter. Good. Now I'm going to go here, right click, copy, go here, right click, paste the formula. All right, but now this is what I've got to do. I've got to drag this down to here. Boom. The active people, but I need some that are not active or inactive. Let's take this person and make that person blank. This person will be possible. So I'm going to hide this. Hide. Okay. This is tricky. I've got to write a filter function that will get rid of active and inactive. Let's see, equals filter, open parentheses, filter this array, comma, include this, does not equal inactive. And let's put parentheses around this, okay? Because we're gonna need an operator. And I can try or, open parentheses, with that doesn't equal active, double quote, close parentheses, comma, and if empty, none, double quote, close parentheses, enter. It's pulled in everybody, but let's go back. Instead of the plus sign for or, put the multiplication sign for and. There we go, the unassigned. So let's unhide. I want to make some other unassigned. So let's take this name out. This might return. Let's drag this into the table. Ready? One, two, three, Look at that. Our blanks automatically showed up, and the possible and might return. Everybody who's active or inactive. And then let's go. Gregor is back. Active. Woo, look at that. Alexia. Active. And Jacinth has turned to inactive. I'm going to highlight this. Go conditional formatting. Text that contains inactive. Custom format. Want bold text, and I want it gray. Okay. Now, I'm going to highlight this. Conditional formatting. New rule. Use formula to determine which cells to format. Where this cell equals inactive, close parentheses. And I want the column to stay, but I don't want the row to stay. So I need to delete this dollar sign before the six. Format. I want a bold font, and I want to grab this gray. Okay. Oh, look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Now we need to test it again. Lupe is active again. We've got inactive now. Possible is now active. We did it. Magico Galvan, we did it. Excel on Fire fans, we did it. Now, some of you may know easier ways to do this. That's fine, but you got to see my process, how I go through and think about it. Because when I saw what Cristiano did, I started thinking filter function, conditional formatting. But I didn't know how they would weave together. And then I also thought about more real world situations where we've got people that are in this limbo zone where we know people who are active, we know people who are inactive, but then sometimes maybe we've sent an email to somebody to check on something and it bounced back at us and we don't know how to contact these people. Or we want to have somebody on the list while they make up their mind about what they're going to do. Magico Galvan, here's to you.